In this video, I'm going to cover solving linear equations that involve grouping symbols like parentheses or brackets. Alright, so let's do an example. Alright, solve and check this equation. 6x plus 2 times the quantity 2x plus 3 equals 16. Alright, now the left side of the equation is not simplified because I have a parenthesis, so I need to do my distributive property here first. So we've got 6x. Now we have to distribute that 2. 2 times 2x is 4x, and 2 times 3 is 6. And I still have to simplify the left-hand side by adding like terms. I now have 6x plus 4x, so that's 10x plus 6 equals 16. Now I have something a little more manageable. Each side is simplified. So I'm going to use the addition property first by subtracting 6 from both sides so that I have my variables on the left and constants on the right. So 10x equals 10. And then we could divide both sides by 2, by 10. So that x equals 1. Who would have thought? That big mess, x is just the number 1. Remember, if you want to write it using a solution set, you would write it like this. Now we want to check our answer. So what we want to do is plug in 1 everywhere for x and use the order of operations. So I have 6 times x. I'm going to have times 1 plus, we're not going to do the distributive property when we check. We're simply going to plug in the value for x. So I have 2 times 1 plus 3. Right, so we're going to simplify inside parentheses. That's the order of operation. I'm just working on the left side of this long bar here. So I could go ahead and do the 6 times 1 now or later, but I still have to simplify inside parentheses. 2 times 1 is 2 plus 3. And we do not add the 6 plus 2. Remember, we're going to do inside parentheses first. And I still do not do the 6 plus 2. I have to do multiplication. 2 next to the 5 is multiply. So that's 6 plus 10, and I get 16. Now, on the right side, there was nothing to simplify. It was already in the number 16. So it does check out. So 1 is the solution to this problem. This is actually a simpler problem when you first look at it. But your answer will be a fraction if you go ahead and simplify this. So go ahead and put the video on pause and see if you can get the solution for x and try checking it and then come back. All right, so let's do this. The left side is not simplified because I have a parenthesis, so I need to again do the distributive property. So this will give me 3x minus 6 equals 10. And then we go ahead and add 6 to both sides. So we have 3x is 16. So I got a fraction. X is 16 thirds. Remember, that doesn't mean you're wrong if you get a fraction because fractions are numbers too. So our solution set we think is going to be 16 thirds. Let's make sure that's correct by checking. So when you check it, we have 3 times x minus 2 equals 10. Often checking is more difficult than solving the equation. So we're going to plug in for x 16 thirds minus 2. Now we're only going to work on the left-hand side here. We are not going to do the distributive property. We're going to use the order of operations. And the order of operations says to do inside parentheses first. So I need to do 16 thirds minus 2. And to do that, I need to get a common denominator of 3. So if I multiply this 2 by 3 over 3, I get 6 thirds. So now that I have a common denominator, I could subtract 16 thirds minus 6 thirds is 10 thirds. Right, so I've simplified inside the parentheses. And now we can do the multiplication, and the 3's cancel. Well, that's nice, so that I end up with 10 on the left-hand side of the equation. And on the right-hand side, it's already simplified. I have a 10. So yes, when I plugged in 16 thirds, both sides were the same number, so that was the correct solution to this problem. Now, this is only one way to solve this problem. There actually are more than one way. There's usually at least a couple ways to solve any particular problem. So I'm going to do this one again with just a little bit different way of solving it. The check will always look the same. So remember, we got our solution of 16/3. Now let's just do this problem again. Same exact problem. Without doing the distributive property, this is sort of a completely different way of looking at this problem. See if you like it. What this basically says is 3 times something, right? 3 times something is 10. So if I know what that something is, I could divide both sides by 3 in the first step. So if you want to divide both sides by 3 first, you can do that. And that way these 3s will cancel and you get x minus 2 equals 10/3. This is sort of a non-traditional way of solving this. Most people go ahead and just do the distributive property and do not work with fractions. Now I need to add 2 to both sides. All right, so if I add 2, well, I need to make this 10/3 plus 2. I need to make that either a common denominator, or I could change 10/3 to a mixed number. So if I do that, I could think of this as, well, 10/3 is really the same thing as 3 and 1/3 plus 2. So my answer is 5 and 1/3. You know what? 5 and 1/3 is the same thing as 16/3. Also, if you could have written the 2 as 6/3 and written this as 10/3 plus 6/3, you would get 16/3. So this just gives you an alternate way of solving that same problem. But when you check it, it does look exactly the same. Or instead of putting 16/3, you could put 5 and 1/3 in. So let's see what that would have looked like if I would have put 5 and 1/3. All right, so I'm just going to put 5 and 1/3 in instead. So we have 5 and 1/3 minus 2. Okay, so 5 and 1/3 minus 2 is going to be 3 and 1/3, right? Now, how do you do 3 times 3 and 1/3? You could think of that as 3 over 1 times, well, 3 and 1/3 means 10/3, and you get 10. I'm still doing the order of operations. So there's just a couple ways of solving and a couple ways of checking. Using the order of operations when I'm checking, using just the addition and the multiplication properties when I'm solving. Let's solve and check this problem. Why don't you try it first? Put the video on pause, see how you do. All right, here we go. On the left-hand side, it's not simplified. Because I have a parentheses, so I'm going to have to distribute the negative 4. Be very careful with that minus sign. You could think of that as plus the negative 4 or just negative 4 times this. So what do I have? I still have the 9x, and then I've got negative 4 times 2x. That's minus 8x, and negative 4 times negative 3 will be plus 12. The left side is still not simplified. I have to do the 9x minus 8x, which is x. So I have x plus 12 equals 11. Oh, how nice. Almost done. Subtract 12 from both sides. And I get x is negative 1. Oops. Negative 1. So it looks like our answer, hopefully, will be solution set of negative 1. Now let's go ahead and check it. Definitely check your work. That is what is so cool about algebra. You could check your work. Make sure you got it correct. So we have 9 times negative 1 minus 4 times, remember we're just simply plugging in x. You're plugging in negative 1 for x. And then we're going to do the order of operations. So inside this parentheses here, I'm going to leave this as 9 times negative 1 for now. Inside the parentheses, I have to do multiplication first. So that's a negative 2 minus 3, right? We do not use the distributive property when we check. Do inside parentheses first. Unless there's exponents, you do exponents next. But if there are no exponents, then you do all multiplication and then addition and subtraction. So I still have 9 times negative 1. And inside parentheses, negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. So I have negative 9 plus 20. And negative 9 plus 20, lo and behold, is 11. On the right-hand side, I have 11. So there you go. I got the right answer. So negative 1 is the solution set to this problem. I'm going to make another video with some more problems involving grouping symbols like parentheses and brackets.